sound volume or so. Don't say anything you don't want the world to hear. That was worth broadcasting.
I would like to welcome everybody to the 2012 Atlantic Dairy Championship Show. We are underway with our summer calves in the ring, so we have our summer calf class in the ring. Exhibitors should be starting to bring their junior calves to ringside, so junior calves to ringside, please. We welcome Judge Mike Heath from Westminster, Maryland, to the ring this morning, and Mike is doing the judging honors for us here today. Of course, Mike most notably judged World Dairy Expo last week, the warm-up for this show. In the ring also helping Mike this morning, we have Alan Kennedy from Antigonish, and Alan will be doing the ringman duties as we work through the show. The summer calf class that is currently in the ring is sponsored by Lewisdale Holsteins, and the best bred and owner of it is sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. So we thank the sponsors for sponsoring this, and if the sponsors are present, we ask them to wave them to make their way through the photo area following the class to have their picture taken with the winner of the class.
It's a real pleasure to judge the Fall Atlantic Show here, to be asked to judge this show. There's a lot of good cattle, a lot of good people down here in the East. What an exceptional class of baby June calves to start the class out today. A very close placing in the top pair, but I just prefer the width of chest and overall power and strength in the first heifer, the overall length to that body. and half of the square tracking on her hind legs is viewed from the rear today. Just a little more total calf in this first calf over the second calf. I would give the second calf the advantage of a little sweeter through that head and a little longer and leaner in that neck and a little more drop to the rib, but I just like to give her a little more width of jaw and power all the way through and length through that body to get her above the first calf. The second calf over the third calf today, she's just neater through that chine area. Calf that's just has more balance all the way through, and calf that's just moving out more comfortably on the hind feet and legs, has more overall length and stretch all the way through that neck and body. The third calf over the fourth calf, she types in with the first two a little nicer today in her overall width and depth and spring to pop to that rib today. Fourth calf, a real long, stylish calf. Just like to give her a little more body, make her a little more calf to get over the ones ahead of her, but she places over the calf in fifth. I just prefer the way she moves out, more comfortable on her hind feet and legs. She's cleaner in that hock, gives more flex through that hock area today. Just a little harder in that back part of the loin today for me.
In our summer calf class, your class winner and best bred known in class, ring number 5, Cottonwood Brett Whisper, exhibited by Cottonwood Holstein. Placing second, ring number 9, Cottonwood Destry Sakura, exhibited by Cottonwood Holstein. Placing third, ring number 1, Big Maple Sid T. Lorena, exhibited by Dunkey Holstein. Once again, our summer calf class was sponsored by Lewisdale Holstein and best bred and owned sponsored by Blue Lions New Holland. Thank you to our sponsors. If we read down the program, our placings are, ring number 1 was 3rd, ring number 2 was 6th, ring number 3 did not show, ring number 4 was 5, ring number 5, Cottonwood Brett Whisper, exhibited by Cottonwood Holsteins, was your best bred and owned and class winner. Ring number 6 did not show, ring number 7 was 4, ring number 8 was 7, ring number 9 was 2nd. Ring number 10 was 8. Added entry, ring number 139, Smiling Beaver Carmen, exhibited by Kyle Bauma and Connor Mann, was 9th. Now entering the ring, we have the junior calf class. The junior calves are coming into the ring. And this class is also sponsored by Lewisdale Holsteins and best bred and owned sponsored by Blue Line New Holland.
Thank you.
No, but I'm saying we should probably change. I did it in varsity. We should probably change the junior calf and maybe get the senior.
In the junior calf class in the ring, we have one that's scratched in this class. Ring number 22 is not showing. Ring number 22 is not showing. And we have an advent entry, ring number 140, Winter Bay Gold Chip Liberty. Ring number 140 is added.
I didn't think about that one. Right in thing.
Well, I was this morning. I was going to the junior.
Not connected. Did you try to set your phone and restart it?
Yeah,
just to see if the logs are back in.
He drinks it, yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
that gallery slice. You know, whatever we'll do, we'll do it. Is anybody here? Just keep an eye on us, make sure everyone looks right. Well, not in the office, I'm excited about that. Trying to pick which text. Well, you could. I just wanted to point some other things to come up with.
Attention exhibitors, the junior calf class currently in the ring. The junior calf class in the ring is in its first lineup. We're completing the first lineup of the junior calves, so the December calves, the intermediate calves, need to be at ringside right away. So intermediate calves to ringside, please. Once again, the class in the ring is the junior calf class. This class sponsored by Louisville Holsteins and Blue Line New Holland. So thank you to our sponsors. So we would like to welcome all our spectators to the 2012 edition of the Atlantic Dairy Championship Show. And if I'm correct, I believe this is the 20th edition of the championship show. It started back in 1992 following the end of the Maritime Winter Fair and the Holstein Breeders taking on their own show and changing the name to the Dairy Championship Show. So I believe we are celebrating our 20th anniversary of this show here today. We'd like to welcome Judge Mike Heath to our show ring today, and he's doing the judging honors for us here today. Judge Heath hails from Westminster, Maryland, which he tells me is handy to Gettysburg, Pennsylvania. He is known for buying and selling cattle and marketing cattle, embryos, semen, and genetic products. Judge Heath had the honor of judging the Holstein show at World Dairy Expo last week and moving through the great classes there. Mike Heath grew up on Spring Valley Jersey Farm in Maryland, which he was owned by his parents. He was heavily influenced by his parents, grandfathers, and uncles. Michael had a passion for exceptional dairy cattle at an early age. After college, he became a professional fitter for 14 years. He currently is a dairy cattle marketer, has owned cattle from some of the top families in the breed, most notably co-owning the Attlee family. Mike has judged extensively for about 24 years, having judged 14 state fairs, 10 state shows, 9 spring shows, 3 fall shows, shows in Mexico and Ireland. And again, most notably the Holstein Show at World Dairy Expo last week. So we welcome Judge Heath to the ring today as he completes our junior calf class. We'll now hand the mic to him for his reasons.
Quite an exceptional class of is here today. I think the calf in first here today, quite handily sorts herself to the top with her raw balance and style. And sure, ring presence. Calf has a lot of dairiness all the way through. Today, that overall length and stretch to her frame, her silkiness, a high openness in her style and her balance places, and her femininity places her over the calf in second today, and also her overall stature all the way through. The calf in second, I would get the advantage just a little nicer in the yoke of that neck and just maybe a little more flex to that hop, but just not the style, length, and stretch and balance of the first calf. The second calf over the third calf, when you got them in line, just has so much more width and strength and power, and I just prefer the set that the hind leg is used from the side, just a little straighter there today than the calf in third. Calf in third over the calf in fourth, just wider through those pins and hip regions. Calf that has a little more length and openness to that rib today. Calf in fourth is a really pretty side profile calf. I just like to clean her up in that hop. See her flex her hop a little nicer today, I mean, especially when you get behind her, like the wider through those pins and hips to get her in the iron. But her overall balance places her over the calf in fifth. She's a longer neck, longer headed calf. She's just sweeter from that side profile. It just has a little more femininity than the wide square calf coming out in fifth today. Thank you.
Thank you to Judge Heath for his reasons on that class. That was the junior calf class that was just left the ring. Your class winner this year is ring number 24, Valleyville Alexander Chief, an animal that went through the sale last night and is now owned by Jeff Stevens, Kingsway Farm, and Adam Clark. Placing second, ring number 17, also best bred known in the class, Charmine B. Braxton, exhibited by Charmine Holstein. Placing third, ring number 14, Cobblequid Mercury Lily, exhibited by Cobblequid Holsteins. Fourth goes to ring 20, Everann Dempsey Gold Digger, exhibited by Everann Holsteins. And fifth, Golden Flow Dempsey Kangaroo, exhibited by Macbeth Farms. Once again, our sponsors for this class were Lewisdale Holsteins and the best bred known, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. If we want to read down our program and bring in our placings, the junior calf class, ring number 11 was 10, ring number 12 was 8, ring number 13 was 9, ring number 14 was 3rd, ring number 15 was 7, ring number 16 was 6, ring number 17 was 2nd, ring numbers 18 and 19 did not show, ring number 20 was 4, ring number 21 was 5, ring number 22 did not show. Over the page, ring number 23 was 13. Ring number 24, Valleyville Alexander Chief, exhibited by Jeff Stevens, Kingsway Farm, and Adam Clark, was your class winner. Ring 25 was 12. And ring number 140, adding entry ring number 140, Winter Bay Gold Chip Liberty, given by Winter Bay Holsteins, was 11. Now in the ring, we have our intermediate calf class. Intermediate calves entering the ring. This class, sponsored by Lyndon Wright Holsteins, Best Bred Nolan, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland.
Talk real close to the lens, I can't tell if you are that way. There you go, even better.
Thank you.
There's something spinning in there. You're fine now. Yeah, make sure the process is busy when it goes through it.
Thank you.
exceptional calves keep classes just keep coming in. A very nice winter calf class. It's been an exceptional show so far today. Heifer that just handily comes to the top today. She just puts it all together in a fine, tight, neat package for me. Not a lot of faults in this first heifer. Today she's a lot cleaner and dairier and rawer than the heifer in second. She's got that longer, deeper, more sweeping rib than the heifer in the second. Just a lot cleaner all the way through. The heifer in second may be a little smooth today, but when you get analyzer, not a lot of holes in her. But today she places over the heifer in third on the way she travels out on those hind feet and legs. She's square tracking from the rear, especially that left rear leg today than the white heifer here. I really, really like the makeup of this white heifer, but I definitely like to see her track a lot nicer on that left rear leg to get her above the first two calves today. She places over the calf in next on her overall width through her chest, her lift and rise to her front end, her overall length of frame and power all the way through. The fourth calf, a really dairy, well-balanced calf. You just like to stretch her out, widen her out, get her, give her a little more size and scale to get her above the first three. She places over the heifer in fifth, just more total balance in this blend, and nicer in that shoulder area. A heifer's holding herself in line a lot nicer today. A heifer's cleaner and flatter than the bone and the hock. And just a heifer that has more overall style. Real nice square cut heifer coming out in fifth. A deep rib, wide pin, big hip heifer, but a heifer tends to fall apart and line up through that front end area. I like to clean her up in that hock to get her any higher in this class. Thank you.
In our intermediate calf class, your class winner, ring number 37, Cowenberg Winbrook 1769, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holstein. Placing second, ring 33, Perpetry Sid Mistifi, exhibited by Perpetry Holstein. Placing third, ring 29, Winter Bay Winbrook Bella, exhibited by Winter Bay Holstein. Fourth, ring 32, Ashlyn Sanchez Sprinkles, exhibited by Wheatsdale and Countryfy Clothing. Ring our fifth, ring 36, Extendale Steady Godiva, exhibited by Extendale Farms. Once again, your intermediate calf class was sponsored by Lyndon Wright Holstein's Best Bred Dog, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. In this intermediate calf class, reading down your program, ring number 26 was 11, ring 27 was 6, ring 28 did not show, ring 29 was 3rd, ring 30 was 8, ring 31 was 7, ring 32 was 4, ring 33 was 2nd and best bred and owned in the class, Perpetry Sid Mistifi, exhibited by Perpetry Holsteins. Ring 34 was 10, ring 35 was 9, ring 36 was 5, ring 37, Cowenberg Winbrook 1769, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holsteins, was your class winner. Ring number 38 did not show. Now entering the ring, we have the senior calf class. So the senior calves are entering the ring. This class sponsored by Extendale and Holsteins, and best bred and owned sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. Once again, in the class, or in the ring at this point, we have the senior calf class. The senior calves in the ring. This class sponsored by Exidale Holsteins and Best Red Belt, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. We once again welcome Judge Mike Heath to the ring today. Assisting Judge Heath in the ring is Alan Kennedy in Nova Scotia. We thank Atlantic Holstein Promotions for once again organizing the show for the Atlantic Area Championship show for this year. Also, just a reminder to exhibitors that Vicki Fletcher is on the grounds today. Vicki is here, set up in the 4-H barn out behind the show ring, and would be happy to help you out with picturing your animals and here today. So Vicki is set up in the 4-H barn. Please make your way there if you would like to have your animals pictured.
Yeah.
Just a reminder to exhibitors of a couple of deadlines that are coming up as we work through this show today. This will be the conclusion of the show season in Atlantic Canada. And of course, we've got a couple of major shows for Canada yet to come, but for Atlantic Canada, this is the conclusion of the show season. And as we conclude the show season each year, we have to start thinking about our All-Atlantic competition. So the All-Atlantic nomination forms were in the last Holstein News with a deadline of November 23rd. So once again, as we mentioned, Mickey is here to take pictures, and we want to start thinking about that All-Atlantic competition and getting those pictures taken and getting the animals entered and in for the All-Atlantics by November 23rd. We also have another deadline that's coming up a little closer on November 2nd. The Impact Cow of the Year nomination forms need to be in. So if we read the quote out of the Holstein News, too often as breeders we hear that our focus is directed toward the show cow. Here's an opportunity for you as a breeder, or perhaps as a club initiative, to recognize a cow that has had an impact on the breed in Atlantic Canada, whether it be in your herd through high production and classification, longevity, her ability to transmit high classifying, high producing daughters, star brood cows, strong cow family, show cow, bull mother, a cow you've merchandised from, or just your favorite cow. We've narrowed this down to four finalists that get their picture and write up in the Holstein News, and then are voted on, and the results announced at All Atlantic Night. So the cow must be bred and owned in Atlantic Canada, and the cow must be alive at the time of entry. So entries are due November 2nd, and we do encourage you to enter your cows. If you do not feel you have the expertise to complete the write-up on the animal, Angela Masters or myself would be very happy to help you with that write-up. And we're just more or less looking for suggestions on cows that you think should be nominated or that you would like to nominate. Thank you.
Amazing Madison with all the strength.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like a headline.
Just a note to exhibitors in the barn, we are entering our final lineup of the senior cav class. Senior cavs are entering their final lineup. All summer yearlings should be at ringside now. We need all summer yearlings to ringside, please.
extremely large and extremely exceptional fall heifer calf class. And these first two individuals at the top of this class today kind of handily sort themselves to that position. With the heifer that's winning, a heifer that just overwhelms the rest of the class, as far as I'm concerned today. Today, over the second place heifer, she's wider chest, a heifer that's fuller in that crop region, heifer that has more lift to that front end, and a heifer that holds herself together a lot nicer in line today. Heifer's a little square tracking and her hind legs and more balance all the way through. I really like this long, tall, raw, stretchy heifer here. In second, she's wanting to be a little bit of a squirrel today. Doesn't give me a lot of looks, but when she does, she easily sorts herself to that position. Today, she's over the third place heifer. She just overwhelms her overall length and stretch through that neck and body, and longer about that head, more breed character about that head, and just more dairiness all the way through. The third calf over the fourth calf. Third calf, not a great big calf when you get her in line and you analyze her. Just not a lot of holes in this calf. And today, when you get behind her over the calf at third, she has more spring and pop to her rib. Heifer that's a little cleaner and flatter in the bone of the hock. Heifer that's wider in that pin region, neater in that tail setting today than a heifer in fourth. Heifer in fourth, you really admire from the side profile, that big, deep, long cage. A really balanced heifer, but a heifer just like to clean her up a little bit. Like to drop that tail head in between those pins when you get behind her. But a heifer that places over the heifer falling out in fifth. Want her overall balance, and I definitely prefer the way she tracks on those hind feet and legs when you get behind her. Has more flex through that hock. She just squarer when you get behind her in those hind legs placement. The fourth place heifer, a big, massive heifer. Just like to change her on the feet and legs. Make her a little more feminine up in that head region and give her a little more breed character there, and just sweeten her up in the rump to get her any higher in this class today. But you really admire overall power and mass. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge Dean, for your readings on that class. Your class winner in the senior calf class, ring number 52, Cobequid Sid Affection, submitted by Eastside, RM, and Cobequid Holsteins, also best bred and owned in class. Placing second, ring number 51, Exkindale Goldwyn Irina, submitted by Exkindale Farms. Placing third, ring 42, Weeksdale Sid Dust, submitted by Weeksdale Holsteins. Placing fourth in the class, ring number 50, Chestico Braxton Cecilia, exhibited by Andrew Sargent and Sky Glenn Holsteins. Placing fifth, ring number 45, Weeksdale Braxton Replay, exhibited by Weeksdale High Caliber and Limpada. The senior calf class was kindly sponsored by Exkindale Holsteins, best bred and owned, sponsored by Blue Line at New Holland. If we read down your program in the class, ring number 39 was 18, ring 40 was 11, ring 41 was 17, ring number 42 was 3rd, ring number 43 was 7, ring number 44 was 8, ring number 45 was 5, ring number 46 was 14, ring number 47 was 12, ring number 48 was 6, 49 was 10, ring number 50 was 4, ring number 51 was 2nd, ring number 52, Cobequid Sid Affection, exhibited by Eastside RM and Cobequid Holsteins, was your class winner and best bred and owned in class. Ring 53 was 16, ring 54 was 9, and we have a change of exhibitor on ring number 54. Ring number 54 now exhibited by Jamie Grant. Ring 55 is 19, ring number 56, 13, and ring number 57 was 15. Now entering the ring, we have the summer yearlings. So the summer yearling class is entering the ring. This class sponsored by ID Holsteins, best bred known, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. Thank you. At this time, we'd also like to recognize our overall sponsor for the show, which is Green Diamond Equipment. The John Deere tractors nicely adorning the ring out here. And we'd like to recognize Green Diamond as an overall sponsor of our show season. We'd also like to make mention of Generations thank them for sponsoring the programs that you're reading and working with today. So thank you to Generations for the programs, and thank you to Green Diamond for being one of our overall sponsors today.
Thank you.
attention to the barn exhibitors. We would ask the junior yearlings to make their way to ringside. Junior yearlings to ringside, please. Currently in the ring, we have our summer yearling class sponsored by ID Holsteins. Summer yearlings sponsored by ID Holsteins are in the ring.
Just an incredible top five in this summer yearling class. The water just keeps getting deeper and deeper and deeper. And I'll tell you one thing, I just judged that other show, but I haven't lost my psyche out here today because I'm seeing some incredible heifers, and what an extreme quality show, and it's really got me pumped up. This first place heifer just sorts herself out to the top today. She has that mass and width and power and strength that, and the combination of airiness with it that you like to see, and a beautiful hind set of legs, just a heifer that puts it all together for me today. Today she just has that width through the chest, spring to her rib, depth of body, and just square tracking on those hind legs as viewed from the rear today than that second heifer. But the second heifer has that extreme ultra cut, a heifer you really love that width of rump and that, and those big hips, and a heifer that's just streamlined. She just has a beautiful front end, neck, and head. Today she places over the third heifer. on that femininity and Greek character about the head, longer in that neck, a little nicer run to the chine, and just a little nicer, just a sweeter appearing rump than a heifer coming out third. The third heifer, or a heifer that doesn't have a lot of faults, like I said, is a powerful, powerful class. But maybe just slopes a little more than I'd like to see. Like, give her a little more depth through that rear rib, changing that rear end structure to get her above the first two heifers in the rear rib structure. She places over the heifer in fourth in her power, or with the muzzle, or with the chest, and her spring to her rib, and just massiveness of rib all the way through. The fourth heifer, a heifer that I really like, the dairiness and the style about this heifer. Heifer's got a lot of comb, but she's got to go back home and bulk up through that midsection and give her some more spring to that rib and pop to that rib and power and mass all the way through to get her above those first four. But a heifer has a good future ahead of her. She places over the heifer coming out next. In her, when you get in front of them, she just has more breed character about that head. She's longer neck. She just when you get in front of them in line, she just holds her head up higher out of her shoulder there today. And she just has more style, balance, and dairiness. The white heifer, I really admire her overall width and depth all the way through that pin region and hips. But a heifer, when you get her in line, she's just not as eye appealing as she is out on the go. It just lacks a bit of style, character, and femininity to being higher in this class. Thank you.
Thank you, Judge Heath, for your reasons on that class. That, of course, was the summer year-end class, class number 5. Your class winner, St. Jacob's Goldwyn Hillary, ring 61, exhibited by Crasdale Firms, Heritage GRD, and T&L Cattle Company. Placing second in the class, ring 67, Weeks Dundee Anakin, exhibited by Chestico, Trivee, and Caran. Ring 64 was third, Miss Duckett, M.S. Duckett, Federal Susie, exhibited by Expendale and Tween Bay. Placing fourth, ring 66, Eastside Atwood Trump, exhibited by Eastside Holstein. This animal was also best bred and owned in the class. Placing fifth, ring 62, Expendale Shottle James Rose, exhibited by I.D. Holsteins. Once again, our summer yearly class was sponsored by ID Holsteins, best bred dog sponsored by Blue Line in New Holland. Reading down the class, ring 58 was 11, ring 59 was 10, ring 60 was 7, ring 61, St. Jacob Goldwyn Hillary, exhibited by Crasdale, Heritage GRD, and T&L Cattle Company, was your class winner. Ring 62 was 5, 63 was 6, 64 was 3rd, ring 65 was 8, ring 66 was 4th and best bred and owned in class. Ring 67 was 2nd, and ring 68 was 9th. Now entering the ring, we've got the junior yearling class. The junior yearling is coming into the ring. This class sponsored by Carol View Holsteins. At this time, we would like to take the opportunity to present one of the very special awards that is presented every year at this show. And this is the Howard Roper Memorial Award. And many of the exhibitors and spectators here today will remember Howard Roper, who was a great part of the breed here in Nova Scotia and the Maritimes for many, many, many years. Operated Atlantic Livestock Sales, or Atlantic was his prefix, involved in the breeding aspects with Nova Scotia, the creation of Nova Scotia Animal Breeders, and the development of that over the years, and the development of his sale business, and just an overall friend of the breed. We also remember Howard as a great artist, and many, many Holstein enthusiasts in Atlantic Canada have a Howard Roper caning thing in their homes. The Howard Roper Memorial Award was created a number of years ago to recognize Holstein enthusiasts or Holstein breeders in Atlantic Canada who have been supportive of the youth, supportive of the breed and the development of the breed, and particularly on that side of the youth, which was something that Howard always appreciated. So each year there are nominees put in from each province and a winner selected. This year we have three members of Howard's family, or three generations of Howard's family here to present the award. So we have his daughter Kathy, his granddaughter Melanie, and his great-granddaughter Catherine here with us today. This year, the winner of the 2012 Howard Roper Memorial Award goes to Jill Bernard. Jill is a key part. Jill hails from Richmond, PEI, and is a key part of the management of Bernadale Holstein's herd near Richmond, PEI. And Jill, along with his wife Tanya, are very active in organizing and promoting the Holstein Show at the local exhibition, the Evangeline Agriculture Exhibition and Acadian Festival. Quoting the June 2009 Atlantic Holstein News, Jill has developed his cow sense over many years and credits the EBI 4-H Showcase, 4-H trips to the Royal Winter Fair, and working with prominent breeders as opportunities for learning and motivation. In recent years, Jill has been able to pass the learning and motivation on to young people that he works with through 4-H or by working with them at the shows. He's been actively involved in many parts of the industry, including 4-H, as an official judge and through the local exhibition. In his role as an official judge, Jill has judged shows such as the Atlantic Spring Showcase and the Quebec International Holstein Red and White Show. Jill has also judged many 4-H shows within Atlantic Canada, including the 4-H show here at the Atlantic Dairy Championship Show last evening. When judging 4-H shows, he is noted for taking time to talk to members and clearly explain his reasoning. When showing in the Burnsdale show screen, Jill often has young people working along with him. In recent years, this has included family members, local 4-H members, or friends from across the region. In 2012, he added cattle from producers outside the local region to his show screen to promote his local show. He's been also been open to allowing these young people to bring an animal or two to tie into the show screen and helping them prepare it. Jill is the livestock committee chairman at local exhibition, along with the organizing all aspects of the show. Bernadale can also be counted on to have one of the largest and best exhibits at the show. Highlight of the show is a two-year-old futurity that has a large enough sponsorship to make the class very interesting. Jill has been a key member of the committee that has been successful in maintaining the interest in this futurity for many years. We'd like to congratulate Jill Bernard on receiving the 2012 Howard Roper Memorial Award. And also, I guess one thing I didn't mention that wasn't in the write-up here, we'd also like to congratulate Jill and his wife, Tanya, on the recent arrival of their new daughter, Marielle, as well. Of course, Jill is busy as always in the show ring, so we're going to get somebody to take his hat off for a minute so he can go over and kindly receive the award from Howard's daughter, granddaughter, and great-granddaughter.
squeeze out Jackie. Yep, pretty sure. We'll go back to the screen with that.
Jill. He's done.
Right.
Oh. Come show your hat. Oh, no, she's entering the place she was in the, right now. Yeah. She's actually doing work right this second.
I said it's not Facebook. Is someone watching?
Doing something. No, I don't have enough friends on my Facebook.
I can
get
it
once a day.
But you know what?
She's famous now?
She's famous. She's Jackie.
The one and only?
The one and only.
People are glad you know.
Depends how much you're done.
Well, what's your opinion? You want more than one of me?
Wow.
Not gonna answer, huh?
I'm gonna drink more coffee. Go happy about it.
What a quality class in the spring yearling class, all the way down to the really well-balanced, well-put-together May Heifer. Out here in this show today, it's not a shame to be down towards the end of the class, because their heifers in county shows, it could do quite well. I think the quality in this show is tremendous and deep, and especially in this class here, just an exceptional group and set of heifers. This heifer that's winning the class today come to the forefront to me for pretty easy. She's a big, tall, long, raw, stylish heifer. Heifer has a great eye appeal and a beautiful hind feet and legs. Today, a really clean hock, just an exceptional heifer. Today, she places over the second heifer. She's taller and longer. She's cleaner, more open in the ribs. She's a flatter bone, neater hock heifer. Heifer maybe has just a little more overall stretch all the way through. The second heifer, maybe just a little more spring to her rib. Second heifer, I apologize for kind of losing her there. She's not a great big heifer, but when you get analyzing her, she's an extremely correct heifer. Has a lot of balance today. Today, I prefer her over the third heifer. She's fuller neck crop area. She's wider in the chest, deeper in the fore rib. Heifers has more width through that jaw area. And a heifer, I definitely prefer the way she moves out on her hind feet and legs. She's square when you get behind her on her hind feet and legs, and a little straighter from the side as well. The third heifer, an April heifer, you really admire her overall dairiness and quality and style today. But just not the overall width to get above these first two heifers. The third heifer over the fourth heifer just more closely follows the type and kind of the first three, or the first two. She has more quality all the way through. She's a dairier, more feminine headed heifer that has more breed character. She's a cleaner boned heifer. A heifer has more style than this square, rugged heifer in fourth. You really admire the width and power and strength of this heifer, but she lacks a little femininity, breed character about that head. You like to clean her up in that hock area, just give her a little more dairiness and style to get her above the first three heifers. But she places easily over the fifth heifer in her overall width and power. She's a wider muzzle, wider chest heifer that has more spring and drop and pop to that rib. Just has more overall width and power all the way through. The heifer in fifth is a pretty high style heifer, but a heifer that you just like to give her more mass and width and power. And I'd like to give her a little more flex to that hock today to get her any higher in this class.
Thank you, Judge Heath, for your placings on that junior yearling class. The junior yearling class was kindly sponsored by Carol B. Wallsteins and Brent Mellon, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. Your class winner is ring number 63, also best bred and owned in class, Eastside Mill Remix, exhibited by Eastside Holsteins. Placing second, ring 75, ID Lenora, exhibited by Nordale Holsteins. Placing third, ring 70, Cobbetwood Aftershock Blanche, exhibited by Weeksdale and Ashland. Placing fourth, ring 77, Winter Bay Golden Lauren, exhibited by Winter Bay Holsteins. Placing fifth, ring 78, Extendale Golden Joan, exhibited by Extendale Farms. Reading down the junior year of the class, ring 69 was 10, ring 70 was 3rd, 71 was 7, 72 was 6, ring 73, Eastside Mill Remix, exhibited by Eastside Holsteins, was your class winner and best bred and owned in class. 74 was 9, 75 was 2, 76 was 8, 77 was 4, and ring 78 was 5. Now entering the ring, we have the intermediate yearling class. This is the intermediate yearlings, sponsored by Eastside Holsteins, best bred and owned, sponsored by Blue Line New Holland. We'd also like to once again recognize our overall sponsor of the show, Green Diamond Equipment, and thank them for their sponsorship of the Atlantic Holstein Promotion shows throughout the year. Also, the programs that you are working with today are sponsored by Generations, and you'll notice the hat bands that the exhibitors are wearing are kindly sponsored by CIQ, or the local affiliate here, the Nova Scotia Animal Breeders.
What's
Once again, in the ring, doing the honors today, we have Judge Mike Heath from Westminster, Maryland. And we welcome Judge Heath here today. Mike grew up in Maryland and on a Jersey farm, and farmed with his parents there. He's a cattle marketer, marketing cattle, embryos, semen, and generally dairy genetics in that business. He most recent judging assignment was the big show in Madison last week, the World Dairy Expo Holstein Show. And we welcome Judge Heath here to do the honors today.
197?
Yep. Well, after the very
Not a large class in this winter yearling, but a very nice class again. Quality definitely runs deep. Two different kind of heifers here at the top of the class. Today I'm going to go with my kind of heifer. I just like the overall length in this first heifer. A heifer is definitely quite a lot longer in that neck area, and cleaner in that neck area, and she's quite a lot longer in her overall body and through that, the length from the hips to the pins in this first heifer over the second heifer. She's a little sharper, cleaner area. Heifer, I prefer the flatness of bone in the hock area. Both heifers have good enough legs, but you can pick on the first heifer being a little set, the second heifer being a little straight. So we'll give that a wash. The second heifer over the third heifer today, well, she just overwhelms her in her frame and just overwhelms her in her just a total heifer, just more total heifer today, just a little longer all the way through. The red heifer, the third, a very correct heifer, just doesn't quite type in today, just not quite large enough in her frame, but heifer you really like, her overall balance is very correct all the way through. If anything, you maybe stretch her out in the neck a bit. But she's a really, really fine heifer. If there was a red show down here, she'd be hard to handle. She places over the heifer coming out fourth today. It's just more types in a lot nicer today with the first two in her overall balance and rib all the way through the spring and pop. The fourth heifer's a big, tall, raw, rangy heifer, but heifer lacks that depth and pop to that midsection. Place over the first three. Place it over the heifer following up next. Just has more width and heifer that I definitely prefer. The way she travels out on her hind feet, legs straight, her leg from the side, just more easier on the go. A very fine class. And the fifth heifer, a really deep, open, square frame kind of heifer. You just like to power out, change her hind legs to get her any higher in this class. Thank you. Thank you, Judge Heath, for your reasons on the intermediate yearling class. Your class winner, ranked number 80, Quality Jasper Aaron, now shown by Browntown Farm. Quality Jasper Aaron, shown by Browntown Farm. Placing second, ranked 85, Crasdale Atwood Susie, shown by Wade Dickey. Placing third, ranked 83, Grand Valley Piccolo Duet, shown by Continental Holsteins. Placing fourth, ranked 82, Lookout Pesky Gold Cheddar, exhibited by Copperwood, Doug Morrison, and Tom Groves. And placing fifth, and best friend known in the class, ranked number 81, Winter Bay Goldwood Lotus, exhibited by Winter Bay Farm Holsteins. The intermediate yearling class was sponsored by Eastside Holsteins, and if we read down the program, ring number 79 was 6. Ring number 80, Quality Jasper Aaron, exhibited by Browntown Farm, was your class winner. Ring 81, best bred and owned in class, was 5th. Ring number 82 was 4th. Ring 83 was 3rd. Ring 84 was 7th. And ring 85 was 2nd. Now entering the ring, we have the senior yearlings. Senior yearling class sponsored by Combination Holsteins. So senior yearlings exhibited by Combination Holsteins. Immediately following the intermediate yearling class, we will have the Parade of Champions for Junior Champion. So exhibitors with entries that were placed first or second in the classes this morning should be bringing their entries to ringside at this point in time. So we'll have the Junior Champion following this class. That will be followed by the Junior Herd class. So the Junior Herd class will follow Champion, and the Junior Herd class will be immediately followed by the Pee Wee Showmanship class. So any of our pre-4-H exhibitors, 9 or under, or under 9, who are keen to get out in the ring here and show us their stuff, please be ready to enter the ring immediately following the Junior Herd class.
this fall yearling class, close placing here today, but when I got in front of these two heifers, I just prefer the strength of jaw in the first heifer and the width to her muzzle today. You get on the side of these heifer, the first heifer is a longer neck, longer bodied heifer today than the heifer in second. I do prefer the depth of rib and maybe a little nicer hind feet and legs on the second heifer, not that the first doesn't have good enough feet and legs. Second heifer over the third heifer, definitely on her hind feet and legs, she just moves out more comfortable with more flex in that hock. Today she's deeper, more well-balanced all the way through. Kind of a pretty framed heifer here in third. You like to give her more mass, and you definitely like to change those hind feet and legs here, move out quite a lot nicer today to get her any higher in this class. Thank you.
In the senior yearling class, sponsored by Combination Holsteins, your class winner, ring number 87, Golden Flow Damian Horner Horoscope, exhibited by Macbeth Farms. Placing second, ring 86, Bullsboro Chapter Katie, exhibited by High Output, Brycon, and Robin Antworth. And placing third, Lonely Maple Lauren Kara, exhibited by Lonely Maple Farms. So reading down the program in that class, 86 was second. 87 was your class winner and best friend known in class. And ring 88 was third. Now entering the ring, we will have the parade of junior champions. So the junior champion class will be coming in here momentarily. This class, the champion is sponsored by Clarence Farm Services. Reserve junior champion sponsored by Sheehy Enterprises. And honorable mention junior champion sponsored by Atlantic Holstein Promotions. So we will welcome our into our ring, the champions, please. Attention exhibitors, the junior champion class is ready to enter the ring. I understand we're missing our first place junior calf and second place junior yearling. These exhibits need to be at ringside immediately.
around town. Spell it out, yeah. That'll be on our online. I need to tell Brian too.
So once again, in the ring at this time, we have our parade of champions for the junior champion of the 2012 Atlantic Dairy Championship Show. Our junior champion calf will be sponsored by Clarence Farm Services, reserve sponsored by Sheehy Enterprises, and an honorable mention sponsored by Atlantic Holstein Promotions. So in the ring, we have our first and second place summer calves, this class sponsored by Lewisdale Holstein. Our first and second place junior calves, also sponsored by Lewisdale Holstein. Our first and second place intermediate calves, sponsored by Lyndon Wright Holstein. First and second place senior calves, sponsored by Extendale Farms, or Extendale Holstein. The summer, first and second place summer year ring, sponsored by I.D. Holstein. The first and second place junior year ring, sponsored by Carol B. Holstein. First and second place intermediate yearlings sponsored by Eastside Holsteins, and the senior yearlings sponsored by Combination Holsteins. And we'd also like to thank Blue Light New Holland for sponsoring the best friend known in all of these classes this morning. Thank you.
Well, I'll tell you what. This is an incredible group of heifers out here in the ring today. A couple more shows left here that I'm sure some of these fellows are going to, and maybe some are thinking about going to, and maybe some that aren't thinking about going to probably should be thinking about going to. That's a handful. So what I'm saying, there's a lot of heifers. The five that I pulled out, some on the rail and some that didn't even make it into this class. That's how good this heifer show is. They need to go to the next level, and I think they'll be extremely successful at the next level. Levels, there's several shows left. But anyhow, let's give them a good round of applause. You should be proud to be from the East Coast and have bred this bunch of heifers out here today. I know I'm proud for you. The March calf, she's long body, style to burn. The winter calf, she's got that width and power, that dairy strength that you like to see. The fall calf, she's got the extreme style that you like to see. The summer yearling, well, she's a load. I mean, she's got the width and the power. The spring yearling, she's got that extreme length and great legs. I'm going to go out and I'm going to tap my junior champion, reserve, honorable mention. I'll come back and Mike will tell you why. Well, this summer yearling, I mean, she's got that width and power. She, like I said, she's a handful is what she is. She's got that width and strength and dariness, and she combines it all together, which is hard to find. Today, that width and power over the senior calf. The senior calf, we really admire her overall style and balance and femininity. Today, she has a little more length and stretch. Through that head, neck, and body region, then the winter calf that I really admire for depth of body and overall width and squareness of frame. Three exceptional heifers, and let's give another good round of applause. Thank you very much. And for the 2012 Atlantic Dairy Championship Show, your first place summer yearling, ring number 61, St. Jacob Goldwyn Hillary, exhibited by Crasdale Farms, Heritage GRD, and TNL Cattle. Your reserve junior champion, ring number 52, Cobequid Sid Affection, exhibited by Eastside RM and Cobequid Holsteins, your first place senior calf. An honorable mention goes to your first place intermediate calf, ring number 37, Cowenberg Winbrook 1769, exhibited by Wheatsdale Holsteins. Once again, congratulations to our exhibitors. Now entering the ring, we have the Junior Herd Class. Junior Herd Class is entering the ring, sponsored by Farmers Dairies. This class is sponsored by Farmers Dairy.
And
just a quick reminder to our pre-4-H and PV Showmanship participants that following this junior herd class, we will have your PV Showmanship class entering the ring. So be ready with your calves. Also following the junior herd class here, we will be presenting the junior premier breeder and premier exhibitor banners. And we thank Merck Canada for kindly sponsoring these banners. And if there is a representative of Merck Canada at ringside, we'd ask that they come out and identify themselves at this time so that we can have them present those banners to our junior premier breeder and junior premier exhibitor winners.
championship game. I just heard you do a championship game.
We would like to have a representative from Farmers Dairy, either a representative of the board or a farmer's producer, if we could, to come out and present the award at the conclusion of this class. So we have a nice banner to present. We would like to have a representative of Farmers Dairy, if we could. Quality runs deep in the best three as well. Kind of hard class to judge, not because they're not good, just because they're that good. First group got the win in junior year, and then two heifers that were right up in there in strong classes in that. I think the summer year one was like fourth, and the fall camp was like in that sixth, seventh, eighth hole. I feel this group just fits together a lot nicer, the balance and the uniformity, and maybe a little cleaner hawks than the second group. The second group, you admire their spring and
pop to the rib a little more maybe than the first group, but just not their overall balance. The second group over the third group, just a little more uniform in immaturity. Third group's probably, as far as placings, probably has the most consistent group as far as higher placings, but just not the maturity or the uniformity of the first two groups today. The third group over the fourth group, just style and femininity. They just have more Greek character up through their heads and a little cleaner and flatter running the hop. The fourth group over the next group today, for me, in a quite easy placing. I just like the hind feet and legs and the balance of this group, maybe the rib in this group than the fifth group. The fifth group over the sixth group, just a little more style, a little more balance through that rump region. But taking nothing away from the sixth group, some really nice calves, a little really deep rib, but just maybe you got some calves and right up to the yearling that won her classes, got the cut to make a cow, but just not the balance and the uniformity in that group to place any higher. Thank you.
I will ask the exhibitors just to hold your herds there for a minute. We will make the announcements of the premier breeder and exhibitor. Your herd class. The class was kindly sponsored by Farmers Dairy. Your class winner, Eastside Holsteins. Placing second, Exkindale Holsteins. Placing third, Cobblewood Holsteins. Fourth, Weeksdale Holsteins. Fifth, Winter Bay Farms. And sixth, Macbeth Farms, Golden Flow Holsteins. So congratulations to all our winners. Now we will present the banners. We'll have Eileen from Merck Canada come forward. She is going to present the banners kindly sponsored by Merck Canada to the junior breeder and exhibitor of the show. This is based on the best six animals either bred or exhibited by the exhibitor. We will start with the junior breeder banner. You're in third place today for junior breeder or honorable mention, Macbeth Farms with 30 points. Runner-up reserve, junior premier breeder goes to Winter Bay Holsteins with 37 points, and your premier junior breeder of the show today with 51 points goes to Cobblewood Holsteins. On the junior exhibitor side of things, in third place with 30 points, Macbeth Farms. Second place with 36 points, Cobblewood Holsteins, and your winner with 37 points goes to Winter Bay Holsteins. And we will ask that the winners of the herd as well as the winner of the exhibitor breeder banners make their way to the photo area for some photo ops. And at this time, we're going to invite the next generation, the future, into the ring for the Pee Wee Showmanship class.
Thank you.